Okay, good morning everyone, or well, almost. We're going to talk about the developing and extending CiviCRM. My name is Luciano, I'm part of IXIAM. We are a company that we implement and we develop CiviCRM projects for different organizations in different countries around the world. So the idea of this session is oriented for developers, mostly. And we will, it's going to be like a workshop, so I'd like to show you how to create an extension, how to do different things in the CiviCRM extension. So if you have never done an extension, you have a first approach how to do it. And if you already have done any of them, well, we can discuss some questions or anything, any doubt you have, okay? First of all, I want to know who is a developer here. Everyone is a developer? Okay, not everyone. Good. The session is going to be technical, so in case someone is like getting lost, that's no worry. I'm going to go another one. Who has developed an extension, a CiviCRM extension already? Anyone? Okay, good. So, well, it's a good idea to see how it's done. Okay, these are going to be the topics, basically. What we are going to talk about, extending CiviCRM, what we can do to extend the CiviCRM behavior and the features. Using CVX, what is CVX and what is meant for? And we are going to see some examples. Then most of the session is going to be about the workshop. We are going to go into a CiviCRM website and we're going to start developing an extension. We are going to use CVX. So yeah, we will do a couple of examples of what we can do. And the last topic is going to be the extension directory, the public extension directory that is in cvcrm.org website. So we can take a look at it. Sadly, I have no internet connection in this laptop, so maybe I can switch another one. Well, we will see if I need to go to any public website. We see how we go. Okay? So basically, CiviCRM is great, we really like it. Many times we want something else, like, okay, does CiviCRM does this or not? No, but you can extend it. But when we talk about extensions or extending CiviCRM, what are we talking about? And basically, this is the main features you can add when you want to extend CiviCRM. You can change the configuration, code base, that means that you are developing something that will change the normal behavior of CiviCRM. Many of the configurations can be changed through the UI, but if you want to do it in the code, you can do it. You can change the style. You can edit your own CSS style sheet. So that's another thing you can develop and you can add in your custom extension. You can edit the templates. You don't like how it looks like, some web page, some form, or you want to change the layout, okay, you can edit the templates as well. We're going to do some examples. Implementing hooks. Hooks are really, really important because you can add your custom behavior to the different aspect of the system in different parts. So it's a really important tool to change the behavior of CiviCRM. We can add custom searches and reports. That's really useful. We can create new pages and form as well if we want to extend and we want to create new sections, new areas of the system, our own module, for example, of CiviCRM. We can do it. We can develop a payment processor as well. Many payment processors come with CiviCRM by default, but there are many other payment gateways around, so we can develop our payment processor to use them. We can write our own API method. That is something that we can use in the future, or we can prepare the CiviCRM to be connected to external systems, so we can write our API method and we can run that with extensions. And the last is like we can overwrite PHP files. That means that if we don't like how the CiviCRM core files work, or we found a bug and we want to create a patch of some files, we can overwrite the PHP file that is in the CiviCRM. That is not a really good option to do it because it has some issues if you want to upgrade a version of CiviCRM, but it can be done at the same time, then some specific occasion is useful to have this. Okay. Okay, using CVX, what is CVX? Basically, when we want to extend CiviCRM, we have different ways to do it. Some versions ago, I think starting from 4.2, if I'm not wrong, or 4.0, all the CiviCRM framework started to use what is called CiviCRM extensions. And what is this? The CiviCRM extension is a module of CiviCRM that can be used in CiviCRM, and it doesn't depend on this content management system, on the CMS. Can be independent use in Drupal, in WordPress, and in Joomla. Before this extension framework, you could extend CiviCRM behavior by developing a custom module of the CMS that you were using. You could develop a Drupal module. Well, at that time, WordPress wasn't working, but you can develop a Joomla plugin, I think. I'm not certain Joomla. And you can add the CiviCRM custom behavior in the module, but it was very specific from the CMS that you were using. With this framework of CiviCRM extensions, the good idea is that we don't need to be worried about the CMS that we are using, because it's independent of that, and we can reuse it in different CiviCRM installations. Okay, so that's a really, really good idea. So, well, we started with this framework. We have a guideline of what we have to do when we are developing extension. It's not very hard, but you need to create some files. You need to follow a guideline. So I think Tim Oten started with this module, this library actually, CVX, that basically is a helper. I mean, it helps you to start developing extension. It creates the basic structure of extension. So from that point, you can start developing what you want. And it's really, really useful. And we are going to see how it works. Yeah. There are some links here where I have the references when I say open project in GitHub. And then the documentation in the wiki of CiviCRM is very complete. I will let you go there. And if you haven't been there, take a look, because it's very complete and you can have a very good approach how to start. Okay. Good. So I think we are ready to, yeah, let's cook some extensions. I like what you want. I need to take this out. Okay, so I have a CiviCRM website here. Just a standard one. I just install it, literally, because I installed it like 5 minutes ago. I'm going to create an extension. I'm going to install the extension here in this website. I'm going to start building some custom behavior I want. Okay. Remember the slide. Where is this? No, wait a minute. What's the main wings? Okay. We have this slide as a reference because we are going to do this. And we are going to use as well the so I have a server, there is if you have any doubt about what I'm writing, let me know, because probably I'm assuming that you know. So first of all, you need to define a folder where you're going to place your extension. Where are you going to put your custom extension? Can be inside the CiviCRM, can be outside, can be anywhere. In this case, we're going to put it inside. So we are going to create a folder inside the CiviCRM installation because it's easier. I think it's this, yeah, sites, default, CiviCRM. Files. Okay, I'm in the file folder of CiviCRM. If I take a look, I have all these folders. I will create here extensions folder, so we are going to put my extensions. So create extension. Some tip, I think it has to have like permission, not full permission, but many permission, because CiviCRM will write on it. Extensions. That's going to be hard to do it like this. Okay, ready. So when I have the folder created, I need to configure CiviCRM and tell it where he needs to go and look for the extensions. Okay, so this is an easy configuration. If you go to CiviCRM, so you go administer, this is system settings, directories. So this is important to let you know where the CiviCRM is. Okay, let's just copy and paste. Okay, cool. Now this is defined. Another thing we need to define is the URL where the extensions are going to be located. That is in the case that your extensions, your extension comes with some resources, some images, CSS or JavaScript files. So you need to define the URL for the website to find these resources. So you do the same in resources URLs. And here in extension resource URL, we put where it's located. And this, in this case, is we will copy this because it's almost the same. And then inside the folder, this is remember extensions, the folder I just created. Good, we are ready to start creating our extension. So we are going to use this library, CVX, to do all the work. Okay. So I go to extensions. I install CVX. If you go to the, I don't have internet connection to go there, but if you go to the GitHub project of CVX, you will find the first README how to install it. It's very easy. It's like two or three steps. And yeah, once you install it, you should be able to run CVX. We have some warnings there, and what we can find here is all the commands that we can execute with CVX. And there are many, many commands to do different tasks. We will go through many of them. You can take a look. It's a very dynamic project. I think they released a new version like a couple of weeks ago. So yeah, it's good because they are like, what the CVX does is to help you to make it easier and make it faster. I mean, it's not going, you don't need CVX to create your own extension. You can do it your own, but with this you are going to do it faster and easier because they have a lot of functional helpers that will help you to create it, okay? So we're going to run the command to create extension. And for that, the command is always is CVX, and then you check there are some commands here, and the one is CVX module. This one, okay? Generate module, create a new CVX module extension. Anytime you want to check what the command does, you can do the command dash H, if I'm not wrong. So you will have the help of this command. What it does and what are the arguments is expecting for Basil. Okay, so when you create the extension, we are going to create it now. Basically, you need the mandatory argument. Here is the name of the extension, and the name. There is a convention for the names or the namespace, and it uses like the Java package's name. Then you have the full. Like a reverse domain name of your organization and your extension. So they chosen that convention for the name of the extension, okay? So in this case, let's say, okay, I'm going to CVX generate module, the name of extension, I will say like cvcrm.module.civicon, because it's the extension I'm creating now. And then you can add an optional argument. This is the type of license you are using for, or we are going to deliver this extension in with this license. Okay, I will use HTTP/2.0. Okay, and then there are another couple of parameters. So, too many arguments. They didn't like it. Because licenses without. Okay, nothing like it. I deleted the license. It's going to put the license for by default. Okay, so. Will I have the extension? Okay. It creates a couple of files, a couple of folders, and it asks me, this is new because in the other version of CVX, as it was in here, it did discover that I'm already in a CiviCRM website, and it asks me if I want to enable the extension I already created. I would say no, because I'm going to do it manually, okay? But you can enable it. The extension is empty, it's just the structure, okay? It does nothing so far. Okay, I have the extension. You can take a look of the structure of the folder I have. Okay, that's the folder. Okay, so it creates all these files. Basically, an extension needs two files to be an extension. One file is info.xml, that is like the where all the information about the extension is stored. We're going to check it out. And the other one is the extension name.php, okay? So this is where, basically, the extension itself, okay? And so let's open the info, xml. No, connect to this. Just a minute. Because it's blocked. So if we check info.xml, we have some information here. This is very important file because we are going all the information that we want to, how we want to define our extension has to be here, okay? And this then is going to be used if we publish this extension in the extension directory. This file has to be like well written, okay? So we just add something. What is the extension name? Is cvcon whatever. Extension or demo description and the same. Who's the author? Who's the email? Release date, version, the stage of development. If it's alpha, beta, or stable, that's three types. Compatibility. That is very important because. We are developing an extension, but probably it can work for different versions of CiviCRM, but probably it's very specific for one version. So it's good to define this here. CiviCRM actually it doesn't check this compatibility when you install the extension, but it's on the administrator when he sees that, okay, this says like, I don't know, CiviCRM 4.4, but I'm using 4.2. You can install it, but you know that probably it's not prepared, it's not ready for that version, okay? So we, in this case, we are going to use this version that is the last one. Right, if we have a comment, we have set. So now, if I go back to the CiviCRM, and now I go to the extensions, nice extension, I should see this extension, okay, it's my extension with all the information I just defined here. So that is why info.xml is important, because it's going to be shown here, okay? So that's the version. And now I can install it. So all the extensions that are placed in the folder I created are going to be displayed in this list. Okay, I have only one now, but I can have more than one. Okay, it's installed, but it does nothing. Okay, so we start doing some.
So your module, your extension file is essentially empty.
Yes, it is empty. It is. But the good thing about CiviCRM that you can install, when you install the extension and then you change it, it's going to take automatically the change you do. Okay, so we can start changing this extension, and automatically we need just to do one step, like refreshing the cache, but then it's going to take the changes we do. Okay. Good. So the first thing we are going to do is we are going to modify some templates. Let's say we don't like how some templates looks like, or we want to change the layout of some form, or we want to add our custom feature, custom behavior. Okay, so how can we modify a template? And in this case, we are going to modify, because this is the example I choose, the contact form, because it's, I think, it's one of the most used pages in CiviCRM. So we want to modify this. We don't like some stuff up here. Some very, very typical requirement is there are so many fields here. I want to hide some fields. That's a very typical requirement. So we can edit the template to hide some fields. And when we edit the template, basically there are two techniques. One is recommended, that is, the templates are files that are called, well, I don't know if you know, but it's called TPL. There are some files that are called TPL. All the TPLs are templates, are the layout of the pages. So we can create the same TPL. We can change the thing we want to change, and that is going to override the original TPL. Okay, that's one technique that it works, but the con of that is, like in any upgrade of CiviCRM, if that TPL changes, your TPL is going to override anyway that one. So you are not going to see the changes in the new version. But if you are aware of that, you can go for that. The other way to do it, that is very, very useful, it works, the con is like it works like in the 95% of the cases, because there are some cases that doesn't work, is that you can create what is called an extra file. So you have your TPL, you don't touch the original TPL, you create an extra TPL, and it will add the behavior you decide, you develop, on the original one. So in case the original one changes, you are not overriding it, okay? You are just adding some behavior. You're going to go for that way. And when you want to edit a template, a TPL, it's not really easy, because you have to look for the strict, you have to create the very same folder structure and the very same template name in your extra TPL. If not, it's not going to recognize that you really want to put some extra behavior in this specific file, okay? That is not really easy to find many times. The one trick is when you check the source code and you just look for TPL. Because many places there are comments about which TPL is being invoked for the page. Okay, so in this case, this is the TPL that is being invoked. This is the TPL we need to create in the very same structure folder. Okay. So we go back to here, and we are going to, all the templates are going to be stored in templates in our extension. Okay, so we need to create the same structure folders in the template API CRM. We create this contact. Yeah. We create a form. CiviCRM contact form. CiviCRM contact. And inside here, we will create our extra TPL that has to be the same name of the TPL, but extra before the TPL. So it's going to be called, create a new one. Let's save it anyway. So, right, it's going to be contact.extra.tpl. Okay, this will add whatever we write here to the contact TPL, the original.
So this is within your extension?
Yeah, this is my extension, yes. And here I'm in the extension folder. Okay, I always, there, I'm not touching nothing from CiviCRM core. Okay? So we have this, and we want to hide some fields, and we are going to use jQuery for that. Okay, it's the most common way to do it. You can use, in the TPLs, you can use any kind of JavaScript, any kind of HTML tags, and any kind of Smarty tags. I don't know if you were about that, but the templates, they are built on Smarty, that is it's a framework for templating, JavaScript, jQuery, most of the JavaScript, and HTML. So any combination of that, we can put it here, and it's going to be added to the template. So let me just add that. I have already done, so I'm going to just copy paste. what we want to do, that's important. What we want to do. I decided that I want to hide this most important issue. I don't use it, so I want to hide all this field. Basically, I want to hide all this row. Okay, so we are going to do that. Just a minute. Where am I? Basically, for that, we are going to use one line of jQuery. So go back to this. This is a trick that you need to add when you are adding some JavaScript. You need to add this Smarty tag, so Smarty knows that you are not using Smarty, basically, that you are using some custom JavaScript. I think you're right. What I'm doing is I'm going to hide this this selector. I don't know if you are familiar with jQuery, but basically you need to define, there are different ways to define how you want to select. I'm defining here by the size, because with dot you define all the elements that have applied these two styles, custom field row and custom 111. This is what is applied there, okay? So basically with this, it should work. If I save it, it's not from validation. From validation comes next. Okay. Let's see if it works. Looks okay. So I have to do nothing. I just have to go again and refresh. Not anymore, okay? So all JavaScript, all Smarty, anything you add, if it's properly done and it's correct, it will be automatically applied, okay, in this case. So I can start developing different things. Let's say I have another example, that is nice. Let's say I want to, okay, I'm hiding here some fields. I want to add some behavior, okay? I want to add my own behavior because I need to do something. And the example I found is, okay, I want to, I have a phone field. I want to validate the phone. I have to add a button that when I press the button, it validates if the phone number is in the correct format, because I really want to have it in with dash or spaces or, okay? So I want to add that behavior. And we can do it in the very same extra template. So this is, yeah. basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a JavaScript function with a regular expression, and then I'm going to add to the template a button that says validate phone, and when you press the button, it's going to execute this function. That's basically what it does. It's a bunch of JavaScript there, but it's not very, very complex, okay? So this is for hiding the file, and then I go and add this. This is a function that validates the phone. I have has to be three numbers, then can be a space or a dash, then has to be between 5 and 10 numbers. So I don't know if it's right, but it's an example. And then what I'm going to, with jQuery, I'm going to add, after the block of the phone, is defined or is identified with this ID. Basically, I'm going to add a bunch of HTML. There's a button, okay? So here I'm using JavaScript, HTML, and jQuery. Let's go, let's see it. Again, I just need to refresh. Okay, I have this button. That's new, that's the button I added. And let's say I want to validate my phone. Okay, I think this is the correct format, it's specifying the function, valid phone number. If I specify another, shouldn't invalid phone number. Okay, so very easy, if you know jQuery or JavaScript, I add in some custom behavior. And the very last thing we are going to do with templates, that's cool. We are going to add some resources and some images. Let's say I want to change the look and feel of this. I want to add some icons because it's some images and I like to improve, you know, the user interface. So what we can do is I can add to my extension images, resources, and then I can call those images from the template, okay? So first of all, I'm going to go again to this extension. I have some images around. So I'm going to create a folder. Inside your extension, you can create any folder you want, any file you want. You are not restricted to do nothing. You can do it. I create a image folder. Images. Okay, so I go to images. And then I'm going to copy, I have some images in another place, I'm going to copy them here. Two icons, a telephone and a, I don't know. So this is hard. Size, the four, five, yeah. No. Images, that. Okay, so I put in my extension two images. They're there. So now I'm going to call those images from the template. I'm going to add, there are two icons. I want to put the email icon here, and I want to put the phone icon here, just to be more graphical. Okay? So I do it again with jQuery icons. Okay, so I'll go back again. I add more behavior. Okay, so what I'm doing is, as I, there is a way to find the URL of the images that is using Smarty and using a custom CiviCRM function that is well documented. If you go to the wiki, developers wiki, documented. So basically, this function is going to check the URL I configured at the very beginning. Remember the extension URL. It's going to go there, it's going to check what extension I'm using, and it's going to get images phone png and images email png. Okay? So I have the URL complete. And then I just add HTML tag for images wherever I want to add it, and using the URL provided. And this should work. Okay, doesn't work, because that's good. Sometimes you need a trick. I mean, the problem here is is permissions and is the web server configuration. Because it's configured that you cannot get direct to these files inside file CiviCRM. So we can add another file to make this work. That basically is changing the configuration of the of this folder. And we are going to add a, what is called a .htaccess. That is a file that modifies the Apache web server configuration. So we are going to give permissions to access here. I'm going to copy because it's here. Okay. Yeah. So just to take a look. This is a very basic file that says, okay, you can have access. Anyone who goes there can have access. It overrides the Apache configuration. Okay, we go again. We should see it now. No. Well, maybe something's wrong. The URL is wrong. Size default file. What if we did two extensions? Well, that happens when you don't define the correct URL in the settings. I think I did it. Insert URL. Yeah. I'll put in that. Okay, well, it should work. For sure. Yeah, it's weird why it is. But always, I mean, it happens, you know, when you are doing a presentation, something doesn't work. But well, something is wrong. Something is wrong. Yeah, something is wrong here. There's one extension that shouldn't be there. I don't know if it's because some configuration or yeah, somewhere. But believe me that if it's right, probably my script is wrong. That should be fine. Why?
So CiviCRM maybe adding.
Yeah, but it worked when I did the, at my house the demo it worked. So yeah, probably some I configured something wrong. But believe me that it worked. So in this way you can add your own resources, your own images, and then you can place it and you can put it in any template you want. Okay? You have to believe me. Good. Any questions so far? Yeah.
What happens when you set up a profile? Do you still get the validate from?
A profile.
Yeah.
What do you want to do with that profile? You want to change the layout or?
Yes, right.
Yes, there is a template. You need to find the proper template for profiles. But you can change the layout. It's the same. The main issue here is to find the correct template to change. And with profiles, there is a path that you need to follow, and that in one point of the path you need to put the ID of the profile. I don't remember exactly. It's like a CRM slash profile slash the ID of the profile. I think is you are using profile 3, 4, 5, the ID you are using, and then you have the TPL path. Okay. I don't remember, but try to check the source code of the page of the HTML and look if somewhere says .tpl, and you can do exactly what we did here with the TPL. Yeah, I did it a couple of times. Okay, good. Keep going. So now we're going to work with hooks. Hooks are really cool. There are many, many, many hooks that you can check in the documentation. I don't have access here. The hooks are called in a specific part of the workflow of the CiviCRM system. You have hook before writing to the database, after writing to the database, when the page is created, when the page is submitted, when the profile is, I don't know. There are different hooks, so it depends what you want to do. You need to use the proper hook for that purpose, okay? So we are doing three basic stuff. One is very typical and very common requirement. I want a default value in my field because I don't want to type in all the time. Okay, so we can do it. So where do you place your hooks? The hooks goes in the main extension file. That is the extension name, usually not always. The main has the last part of your namespace extension.
So it can't stop working.
there in the week. So we go to this file, and if you go there, you will see that there are some many mass texts around here. Well, this text is created by CVX. It performs some actions that are useful, but we are going to add our own action. And we are going to use for putting a default value, there is a hook that is called build form, that the hook is called very and the after, no, after, before the form is going to be shown to the user. So in that specific moment, we want to specify a default value. Okay, so that's the hook we need to use. And we are going to just put a very simple default value. Usually you have to put, when you create a hook, I'm going to do it here, you put the name of your extension, the last part of the name of your extension, and then the name of the hook you want to use. In this case, the name I want to use is CiviCRM build form. This hook is called just before the form is shown. Okay? And I'm going to add some custom files. This is PHP, so if you're familiar with this. Okay? This hook is called before every single form of CiviCRM is shown. Okay? So if we want to add some default value to the contact form, we need to be sure that the hook was called for the contact form. How you do that? You do it using this variable that is passed to the hook with the name of the form. So the contact form, the name is CiviCRM contact form contact. So we want to add these behaviors only for this form. You can add the behavior for different forms, for contributions, membership, all the forms that are in CiviCRM. We want to add it only when the form is displayed for add, for creating a new contact, not when editing or not when deleting. And basically what we're going to do is to add a default value to the source field. So every time we create a contact, it's going to say, well, the source is CiviCRM London, because we are here, okay? We save it. Yeah, I need to buy it. And just refresh.
So the documentation covers the hooks and
yes.
The form names? And
yes, yes. The hooks documentation is really good. I mean, it's very good. Yeah, it's the same, I have no access to check it out, but you will see the list of all hooks, and then you have examples how to use them. It's really, really good. I have this. Default value, okay? I said that for... No, it's not. Better? The one who is like looking at that, yeah? I have a default value now. So, you can use it for any field of this form or any form, okay? It's easy.
So you can change any parameter about any form using that sort of...
Any parameter is like very wide. I mean, you can change it, yes. But when you build, I wouldn't say any, but you can change many. Yeah. But default values, any default values, yes, for sure. No, it's not either. Okay. What about validation? I mean, we did some validation about the form, but there was some custom behavior, but we don't want to allow a contact that doesn't follow our validation, our guidelines. So we can add the validations using hooks as well. Okay, so we are going to use a different hook because the hook for validations is going or needs to be called after the form is submitted because we receive all the values and then with those values we decide what to do. If they are not in the proper format, we don't validate it. Okay, so we're going to use another hook. And this hook is called validate form. And very similar to the other one. I mean, we need to define which form we are going to use, because this hook is called after any format is submitted of the CiviCRM. So we want to validate only the form contact, there are some, well, some things that you need to get here. I mean, you get the submit values, all the values that are already in the form, and then you check that, for example, the contact source is still in Call London 2014, because even if it's a default value, someone can go there and change it. But we don't want to allow that someone change it, okay? We save it, and we try to check if it works. Okay, we just have some. No, I don't want to put this. Okay, I'm gonna save it. No, I cannot go through. Okay? Because the validation says that needs to be CiviCRM 2014. If I change it, I can't do it. Great. Thank you. Yeah. Right. The last thing we are going to see about tokens, about hooks, are the tokens. I don't know if you are familiar with tokens, but tokens basically are variables you can use in mailings and in PDF letters. So you use that variable, and you print or you send a bunch of emails or letters, and that variable is going to be replaced for the actual value of the contact you are sending to, or you are creating the letter, okay? There are a list of tokens available in CiviCRM, but many times you want your own token because, okay, I want to put some, well, you can create your own token using hooks. So for this, we're going to use two hooks. One for creating the token, and the other one to specify how to replace that token, which is the value that we need to replace that token, okay? And we are going to print some PDF letter, and so I copy paste. I'm going to put here. Okay, first hook is called tokens. Here you add all the new tokens you want to add. I create two because we are going to use only one because this is an example I use for some customers. Many customers they don't want to put. You have token for every part of the address, like a street, a zip code, province, state, country, blah, blah. But the customer says, "I'm lazy. I want just to have one token and put everything there. So all the letters or all the mailings, I'm putting all the tokens." Okay, so let's create one token that's called complete address. So it will be replaced for all the complete address. So this is a token. Here you put all the new tokens. And then you put the behavior of the token, how it's going to be replaced. So in the case of the complete address, there's a function in CiviCRM that automatically gets all the complete address, and that's it. It's easy. But in the case you will need to do something more complex, well, you can put all the behavior here. You can check the connect to the database, you can retrieve data from another source, whatever you need to do can be done, okay? For that, I use the token values hook. That is where the behavior of the tokens are defined, okay? So let's check it out what it does. Let's set some contacts and let's create some PDF letters. Let's do some. Okay, let's see. Print PDF letters. Okay, so now if I go to insert token, I will say, okay, I want the name, this is the name, and then I want the complete address. This is new, I just created it. Okay, that, let's say, it's easy. So when I print this, it should put the name and it should put the complete address. Let's see. Okay, voila, complete address, okay? This is very a very easy example, but you can do very complex example in the token. Especially because tokens, you can use tokens that are related to the contact. CiviCRM doesn't have tokens with related with contributions or memberships here. So many times the organization wants to send a letter saying, okay, thank you for you have donated like 1,000 euros in the last year. That token, like how much the contact has donated, is not a token. You need to create. But you can, so you need to create the token, and then you have to specify the logic to retrieve all the data to put there. Okay.
You could do it like you came to our event last week.
Yeah. You can do
this event.
Yeah.
I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah. You can use any information in the CiviCRM, but then you need to do it yourself. Okay, so this was token. I don't know when I need to finish. I think in 5 minutes, so I'm going to go fast. Okay, I'll have that. We are going to create custom search. That is good. I'm going to create a custom report, one very basic web page, and that. And then we. So custom searches. I don't know if you're aware, but you have many searches in CiviCRM, but you have here a section for custom searches. And by default, CiviCRM comes with many custom searches that is very specific for searching with specific fields or elements. What happens is we want to create our own custom search. We want to search contacts that match this specific filter, this specific criteria. Okay, we can create our own custom search. Creating the custom search is easy, but then developing the custom search is kind of more complex. You need to know about PHP, you need to know about all the entities in CiviCRM, but it can be done. So let's say we want to create a search of birthday. Okay. Who has a birthday this week, this month, previous month? Okay. We are going to use CVX for that again. Then we can do it manually, but there is a function in CVX that creates the basic structure of the custom search. Then you need to develop that. And it's generate search. Okay, with this one, we can create that. So let's say I want to create CVX generate search birthday. Then the search is going to call birthday. You can put anything. No. Images. No. Sorry, I'm in the wrong path. When you are when you execute CVX and you get that error, that means that you need to execute in the root folder of your extension. I was inside images. So again. Yeah. So well, the custom search was created. It creates two files. One for the behavior and the one who creates the extension, the custom search itself. So if I open the folders, if I go to CRM, CiviCon, form, search, birthday. Okay, this is it creates some example. I mean, no, this is not. This is where I'm checking the wrong place. If we go to mouse pointer, CRM, CiviCon, refresh folders, thank you, form, search, birthday. Okay? This is a custom search, PHP. It copies just a standard custom search. I have my custom search, I'm going to paste it there. So we go to be faster. Okay, that's the custom search I developed for birthday. Okay, then we can show if you want to see how it's done, I can show you. Save it. Now, to let CiviCRM know about we created a new custom search, it's not automatically. We need to run one command, or we need to go to one URL that basically will clean all the cache of CiviCRM. tip that URL is CiviCRM/menu/rebuild-reset1. We'll clean up the cache. Now if we go to custom searches, birthday, I says there. The extension was done. And that's the search itself, that's what I developed. Like, okay, I want to check all the contacts that have birthday this month, September. Until 30, no? September, computer search, I get the contact, then I can do some stuff. Yeah, but some notices, some matter. Okay, I have the contact. So let's have the birthday. I mean, it's working, okay? We created a custom search. From this point, then you can create the search you want. Let's go fast. Let's create a report because it's very fast and we can do it.
So in your definition, which you've done, you know, the specification element of it, you've created, specifying the fields and
for the custom search, yeah. But with CVX, the good thing is like it creates all what you need, and then you have the file, and then you have to modify one file. Okay. You go there, and you don't need to worry about creating all the custom search inside CVCRM, the cache. It's coming to CVX does everything. Then you need to develop what you want. Same for reports. There is a command. We go fast anyway. There's a command to create a custom report. That's a very typical requirement. That is CVX generate report. Okay, CVX generate report. I name my report. I say where it's going to be the URL of the report. And that's it. No. Too many arguments. Bueno. Yeah. You need to specify what. No, the problem with my page is like I need to put --. --. I'm now null. Okay, I created a report called log extended because I want to extend the log report. And yeah, it creates all the files I need. So I go to the specific file and then start developing what I need. And that's it. I do the same with us. Custom searches. I clean the cache, report is there. Okay? The same with a web page. Let's say we want to create another page of CiviCRM to show something or to do something. This is CiviCRM fast. CVX generate page. Yes, the name of the page. All right, this is the example I have, and the URL of the page where you are will access to. Good. Yeah, done. So now, of course, it created. I didn't do anything to the page. It created some sample page. So I clean the cache again, menu, rebuild, reset. Okay, so now if I go to the URL I defined for this page, that is CiviCRM/Gritter. I have a page. This is the example page that CVX creates, but then I go here and I can do what I want. Okay? That's the page that creates that we can check it out. Very fast. Project. You can see that it creates all the folders, all the fields you need. And this page is in page reader. And this is it has the structure. Then you can do whatever you want. Okay? So, we can do many other things with CVX. it's a really good tool, very, very good, and developing extensions is what they say. It was never that easy as is today. Yeah. Of course, you need to know about PHP, about jQuery, about many stuff, about CiviCRM, the entities, how it works, but creating all the structure is easy. It's very, very easy. So what do you do after creating your extension? What should you do? Sending CiviCRM workshop. You publish it in the extension directory. What is the extension directory? I don't know if you've been there, but in the website of CiviCRM, there is a directory with all the public extensions developed by the community. Okay, so first of all, if you want to add some custom behavior, what you do? You go, you come here and you say, okay, it's already done. Most probably it's already done. I mean, someone, I always say that if you have a problem, someone had it before you, for sure. So you can check here, and then, yeah, you can find many, many extensions. You can download it, and you can install it, and it's very easy. If not, if you develop your own extension, and you finish, and you want to share with the community, you upload it here, okay? So it's ready for everyone to use it and to even give you feedback about if something is not working or to improve it, or there are many cases that someone take an extension and improve it and put it again in another, a new version, a new release to the directory. So it's the way how to collaborate inside the community, okay? Well, these are the resources if you are looking for documentation about the development, about the extension, the forum, the developer's wiki is really updated and it's really good. That was years ago. And then you have the IRC channel, so if you want to enter there to the CiviCRM channel, you can ask questions and you can participate, okay? And that's it. Thank you very much. I hope it was very useful.